Hello and welcome back to my walkthrough of Final Fantasy XV. In the last episode, we met up with Corleonis, known as Cor the Immortal and Marshal of the Kingsguard, and he has led us to show Noctis the idea of the Royal Arms, as he needs to find the Royal Arms in order to collect their power and actually, become the leader that he is destined to be. And that's left us here at the Kikatrich. Huh? I really don't know. Kikatrich.
What is this place?
It appears to have been a shelter.
People lived here?
Those seeking refuge from war, most
Wars.
Likely.
Wars. Huh. What are they good for? Wonder if anyone's still living here.
So a Kikatrich trench here, which is, as you can see, a dungeon. Huh. And the first
What's
dungeon.
This? A cable? Wonder where it leads.
Well, we can follow it and see.
Huh?
A generator?
So it would appear.
Might still run. Sweet, it works!
Oh, then there was light.
Oh man, I do love me some light.
So. This isn't a particularly. It's not a particularly confusing maze, this one. Most of the dungeons in this game are rather unique. I do very much enjoy the various. The different sort of strands of them.
What?
This one in particular. It is one of the more simple ones.
My bad. Kick the can.
You are killing me here, big guy. Are you trying to give me a heart attack or something?
Whoa.
If it's all the same to you guys, I'd rather not get buried alive.
Yeah, let us be quick.
So, there we go. We get a carbon bangle there, which I assume is a better bangle than many of the others that we have. And now we'll start going through this door here.
Eyes on us. The second we turn our backs, bam!
Quick.
So, this sort of theme is the dungeon theme, and you hear it in all of the various dungeons of the game.
FYI, we already tried it.
So yeah, so as you can see, certain doors in the dungeon are locked and will remain locked until they can only be opened from one direction. I'm pretty sure. Oh, we do actually have an extra flask. That's awesome. So, let's create a blizzard spell. A nice, powerful one. So, we need 43... 40... What you will find is that in most of these, in the majority of these dungeons is that, what's quite cool is that there will be elemental, there will be deposits for you to actually, absorb, energy from. So we get a dual cast Blizzara Thundara, and we'll craft that up. So we definitely, the reason we're doing this is obviously, so that we actually have, some more spells.
Anybody home? I'm coming in! Locked. Total shocker.
If something's worth locking out,
it's worth seeking out.
The other nice, the other things that I really appreciate about this game is like the little touches, the fact that, all of these guys have, Ignis, Prompto, Gladiator, they all have unique and individual sort of things to say about all of these situations.
And their tormented souls just sort of remained behind.
Nope.
So another route that is blocked us from us.
Maybe.
This isn't.
I don't know.
Whatever it is, it's playing with us.
Hey, wait.
What?
Need to brace for this.
So, we get an Aurus Call Ascension coin. We can also head over here and find the first of the deposit.
On three, you open the door. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay. Here I go. One, two, three.
No good. It's locked.
You're joking, right?
Different door, same story.
No luck here. It came from... What is it now? Huh?
What is it?
That wasn't there before.
That wasn't there before, no. A gleaming choker. Aha! So, we get our first enemies, and they are a bunch of these little... goblins. Nice, simple battle there, but you get the idea as to what sort of... a lot of these little dungeons are like, and that you sort of, you might get enemies sort of surprising you or jumping out from places that you weren't expecting, stuff like that. So, I think the only place for us to go is actually this way.
First time through here, right?
Looks it.
It's just a lot of things I really appreciate about like how they do these dungeons and how they have everyone sort of respond to the various things that you do. So if you go like down too many wrong paths and stuff like that.
A dead end.
I could have sworn this was it.
Well,
somebody turn on a light.
Whoopsie. So.
Not good to throw daggers in the dark.
So, we take care of those goblins. There we go. So, this is, the dungeons do have this unfortunate sort of habit of occasionally you will just sort of end up with like, these very sort of cramped spaces.
Well, just gotta keep moving.
You know, you end up in these very, very cramped spaces and, trying to do all of your usual, you know, the combat in this game is pretty much at its best in these wide open areas where you can sort of fly around and really attack everything from different angles. Whenever that's sort of really closed in and sort of narrow and quite difficult, sort of, you know, when you're sort of rubbing shoulders with all your allies and all this sort of stuff, it can be a little bit more difficult. But there we go, another cable. Another item. You want to pick up virtually every item that you find along the way in these sort of paths, because let's be honest, you're not going to be returning this way particularly often.
Don't lose your cool.
Says the panicky one.
Nice, another one.
Okay, so more goblins. Not too difficult there. We can,
no use hanging around here.
Once again, trigger the next generator. Give us a bit more light. I think that is the way we came from. Yes, it is. That was a dead end, so we'll start heading down this way. We have a door that we can open. I'm pretty sure this is a entirely linear route in that you can only there is only one door that you can open at a time. So
wait, hear that?
So we'll get some fire. It's an empty room.
Nothing.
That's weird.
But if you do head into it, you then encounter some more enemies, some tarantulas. Ouch.
All right, you hate bugs.
Me? Yeah, can't stand them.
Same here.
Ooh, this looks promising.
In an ominous sort of way.
Stay sharp.
So, we'll start heading down this path. We get an auto crossbow, which is another one of the various weapons that Cid can upgrade. Let's just check what's down here first. A high elixir and a dead end. So we turn down to this area, another small storeroom, it looks like. And now we see the main enemy of this area, one of the main areas, this Arachne. Obviously a large spider-type enemy. We'll just quickly Libra it and then probably dump a load of high-level magic on it. Sounds like a good plan. It is weak to fire, strong against lightning, weak to machinery and great swords. So if I just quickly put that on. We'll cast fire, and then we also have the Blade of Brynir, obviously, being a...
Let's make sure we hit the bad guys.
So, an electric-type enemy, as you can see.
We're in the home stretch.
And once again, the Blade of Brynir is an excellent weapon to have at this point. Makes this battle a hell of a lot easier than it would be without it. And there we go, lovely. Take it down.
It's over.
None the worse for wear.
Indeed, none the worse for wear. So, pick up another elixir. And now if we just check the map. So I think this is just opening the doors back onto the route that we previously were on. And then heading through here. Is the path we actually want to take. So, here is the tomb of the Conqueror. And inside we have another one of the many royal arms, one of the 13. So, there we go. We get the Axe of the Conqueror, so we now have two of the royal arms.
More or less. At this rate, he'll soon rival his father's legacy.
The Copycat King.
Adeline. Well,
so obviously,
what's it like?
Like I've got some tricks up my sleeve.
No need to put on a magic show for us.
But it never hurt to practice.
So, you'll notice there that obviously it now gives us the ability to return to the entrance. Well, you can return to the entrance of any of the dungeons if you just go to the map screen. You can see there is a button to return to entrance. We're not going to do that quite yet because there are a few doors that we didn't actually open on our way here that I'm rather interested in.
This supposed to keep us out?
Or keep something fun.
No dice, won't budge.
For every lock, there exists a key.
Or like a magical key that can unlock any door. Like from the video games.
Or that.
So, obviously, there is some other part to this. And essentially, so the way it works is that if every one of these dungeons also has an extra path to it. An extra mission involved. But we can only do them once we've got like far into the post-game. You need to be well into post-game, very high level as well, just to even consider taking on these sort of enemies, because they're pretty brutal, and they do an awful lot of... they do a lot of damage, and some of those challenges are, that's nearing the hardest parts of the game, and that's what you want to be aiming for, I guess, if you want to do the complete run of this game, which is indeed what I am hoping to provide for you guys here, a true walkthrough to everything. So, like I said, there are some things back here that we didn't open. I'm just going to check just to see whether they now do open. If they do, that would be rather interesting. Or it might be that we actually had a door, maybe from the previous bit that we were meant to open. Would that have given us access to? No, it doesn't look like it. So, let's see if these now... So this now opens, as you can see. We can head down. In here is some...
Above us!
Look out!
But we can find an ether. And I think this links up, actually, with the other stairwell over here. So that's those two, and then I think that was locked anyway. It's now open. Still not open.
It won't open.
So maybe the other door will actually. I'm pretty. Yeah. So this we can now enter here.
I've ever seen
oh, totally.
We can actually collect some lightning energy. There's usually one of each type of, you know, one of fire, lightning, and ice within every single dungeon. We'll get another rusted bit, and now we can head down here, and I'm pretty sure this will actually loop around. So I'm pretty sure all of these doors essentially open
it's
once
safe,
you sort
right?
of get that first bit where I think they go, you know,
hey,
that wasn't there before. So, there we go. So, once again, we've linked back around. We've collected everything within the Kikatrich Trench. Yeah. It's very much a mouthful. And now what we can do is we can return to the entrance and nice and safely.
Yeah.
Finally picked up. Thought I'd lost another king.
Just busy building my arsenal.
Good to hear. I have a task for you. The Empire's begun construction of a new base along the road west to the sky. I need you to put it out of commission. If left unchecked, it will cost us access to the west and all the royal tombs that lie beyond. I believe you've met Monica. She can fill you in on the details. Go see her.
What's up?
People to see, bases to burn. Let's go see Monica at the outpost.
Okay, so we now have a declaration of war.
Come to think of it, we did
spy
a large structure.
Yeah, hard to miss an ominous thing like that.
Ain't gonna be easy taking down a whole stronghold.
Can we really do this?
The Marshal believes we can, or he wouldn't have asked us. But first things first.
Right. Let's head back to the outpost.
So, indeed, we now have a new mission, a new plan. So, we'll run back to the Prairie Outpost, but rather than continuing on with the story, we actually have some submissions that we can now do. We want to head back towards Hammerhead.
Good morning, fellas.
Because I'm pretty sure now. So, see, there's a question mark there. Now Cindy will now offer us. Cindy will now offer us some quests as well, and that is one that we want to. One of the ones that we want to take on. So, we'll make our rapid return back to the Prairie Outpost.
Man, who knew Kor was such a badass?
I'm just glad he's on our side.
And now we want to talk to Monica again, I believe. So, there she is.
Your Highness. The Marshal has apprised me of the plan. We've found a back door into the Imperial base. I'll mark the route on your map. The way is secure. You should be able to gain entry relatively easily.
So, there we go. So, we've been given the information that we need, but now, before we actually get ahead of ourselves and actually attempt this, what we want to do is we have a load of side quests that we can take on. So, first one, we're going to return to the car. So now that we're back at the car, what we're going to do is we're going to head over to Cindy and take on her quests.
Oh, hey there, Prince. Howdy, y'all. Are y'all on break?
More or less. Did you need help with something?
Don't you worry. This girl ain't got nothing up her sleeves this time.
Work got you busy?
Most days that's true. But today's a little different. I was just about to step away from the garage for a spell. One of our regulars told me they found something real special lying around. A rare can of car wax. Reckon y'all could use it on the Regalia, so I'm on my way to pick it up.
For us? Let us do the legwork.
You sure?
It is our car.
I tell you what, you got a point there. Well, if y'all insist, who am I to argue? Might take a little while to find it, though.
Fine.
Fella found it, but didn't have the foresight to grab it.
So, we're supposed to venture out into the wild, find the wax, and bring it back.
That's the plan.
Unbelievable. Cindy was willing to go out of her way and risk life and limb for us. She's the best.
I love Prompto's obsession with Cindy. Anyway, so what we're going to do is we could head over to the Three Valleys. Actually kind of wish that we had actually done some more stuff that we actually would need to do around this area too. Like Dave's mission. So what we're going to do is we're going to head over to the Three Valleys first. And then we're going to start making our way across.
Radio, come on.
Gotcha.
Like, it's not too far of a walk, to be honest. So we'll head over here, and then we've got a fair number of small side quests that need taking care of, including this one for Dear Cindy. If we actually go to our quests and we choose the ever regal Regalia, you can see that it's a fair ways away, but we'll certainly make relatively swift progress towards it. So we make. We'll continue to head over this way. And then we'll be over back by the Three Valleys parking spot. So, Three Valleys parking spot. So now, what we want to do is, from here, we want to head up this path, follow this road, essentially. Along this road, we will find some people who are having a bit of trouble. Be it either someone who's crying out for help or some people who have problems with their car. Regardless, we go in there, we help them out, and then and then we will continue to make our way round. We'll probably head up, do bits of Dave's quest as well. Seeing as we're going to get pretty close, probably around that area too. So, let's have a look, see, where are we? So, that looks like a car, straight ahead. Hopefully, this will be the source of our next mission. So, hello you.
Just my luck. I need to go home.
So obviously we do have a repair kit, so we should be fine. Stranded on the sand, we'll get nice and completed.
Finally, thanks for the help.
Ooh, that couldn't have gone any better.
So we get a chunk of gil. And now we want to head over here towards this junction. The reason we want to be over here is we have some more missions to do. We should, I say hopefully, obviously. But yeah, we should hopefully run into another mission around this area. Wonder if there's anything useful around here. Like another recipe or something, you never know. So anyway, we want to head all the way across. So you can hear there a hunter calling out for help once more. So tired of running, find the person in distress again, wherever they may be. I'm assuming they're somewhere around these rocks and stuff, but I might actually be wrong. Ah, there they are. Cool. So, we have a potion.
Thank you so much.
All in a day's work.
Sweet. So, now we need to head over to where Cindy needs us, which is actually through here, down into this little, down into this cave. Because it's dark, that means there can be demons in here, and generally it'll be just the small goblins, so nothing really for us to worry about.
Time. Let's hope it's not a tragedy.
It sure ain't a comedy.
Wow, the color's amazing.
So, we pick up some more.
This is the place Cindy mentioned, right?
Should be. Let's start looking.
So, there's another poster here for us to find. Orienteering checkpoint B. A morsel of meat will be your treat, but the taste of victory lies further ahead. Seek where wheels stop in order to keep rolling, where man harvests the blood of the earth.
That's it!
What's what?
I've come up with a new recipe.
I can taste test for you.
So there we go. We get another one of Ignis's many, many delicious recipes. Uh-huh. And we can continue looking for, and we can continue to try and find this bottle of wax for the regalia. So Cindy's quests all involve sort of giving you various upgrades to the regalia. These can be as simple as like the wax, which I think just means it doesn't either it might increase it might
looks pretty old.
It's not old. It's arrow wax. Ring a bell?
Not a one.
Unsurprising, given it's 3 decades old.
This stuff's older than we are.
So the various like wax and stuff like that, all the things that you get from Cindy essentially improve your car. Sometimes, and certainly some of those are sort of like better than others. Some will like increase your top speed, for example, which is obviously quite handy. Means you travel around that little bit faster. so that you don't have to refuel so often, or yeah, there's lots and lots of different sort of examples that they actually sort of can take. So anyway, so now what we want to do, we actually want to so what we want to do is we want to head up, keep heading forwards. We'll appear out here, and now we have some more quests. We want to take on Dave's quest, which is actually very close by, as you can see. There better be some very good meals that require us having all of these peppers. So you sort of want to head towards like the center of the area that is sort of marked out here. And we'll be able to find the dog tag. I think it's around here. There we go.
This must be it. Let's take you to Dave.
So we're not going to do that quite yet. Actually, what we're going to do is we're going to head over to... we're actually going to head over to...
I think I got a pebble in my...
We want to head south a bit, essentially.
Take it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, good, that is south. Ooh, that was another procurement point that we missed on our last run through here. Some more bird beast eggs. So what's important is also, you know, you might be thinking, well, we're just picking up the same items over and over again, but what's nice is that when you go to the different areas of Lucis, so once we get access to Duskai or Klain, then you will find that obviously you will get a different common drops and stuff like that, which is quite cool. So we're heading straight down. We're gonna find a an item soon.
Help! Is anyone there?
We actually hear a another person in distress.
Watch where you're going.
May well be in this building. Would be my first guess. There she is, lovely.
I can't thank you enough.
I can't thank the game enough for that not being the same hunter over and over again. We finally helped someone else. Anyway, so now what we need to do is we need to... So there should be another map piece somewhere around this area, essentially. As we find another treasure. Being quality building stone. So, you know, stuff like that, it might not seem particularly valuable now, but what it probably means is that it's probably valuable in some way because it's a really good item for example, crafting good spells for. Anyway, we find another piece of the very large map. And we will indeed follow that
map.
So we're going to find this piece of the map, and then I think there'll be another piece of the map for us to find straight away afterwards as well. Is that someone in distress? It looks like it is. Another We are rattling through the side quests right now.
My car and walk home.
So, we do roadside assistance as well, because we can.
You saved me a long trek.
Ooh, that couldn't have gone any better.
So, we help another guy with their broken car. We get another 900 gil. Like I say, we are really nailing some of these. We are, running through these missions. So.
Closely resembles. Are you listening?
Yeah, salt. Love the stuff.
How did you manage to graduate?
Okay, so now what's next for us? Well, we have another item. Some Aledian sweet potato. Lovely. Don't think there's anything around this area. So let's see if we can't find the next piece of the map. I feel like we've already been in this. We've definitely been here. And it looks like that treasure, which was once the Blade of Brynir, it's either respawned. So is that another Blade of Brynir, or is it something else? It is another Blade of Brynir. So these pieces, they do actually respawn, which I find is rather impressive for us, actually. Very useful. Okay, so. Now, finding the pieces of the map is a lot harder than we got lucky about for the last two times that we've actually done this. What about there? Yes! Wonderful. So we find
and
that.
And here's another one. How many more are there?
Well, just to help you out here, Noct, we're actually going to find another one straight away. We want to head straight up and head out and then up once more. I think it is actually around here, maybe. Maybe not. Don't know. Or maybe I need to be finding them in order, is the question. So, let's just quickly check the map. To be fair, I think we could actually... this one's not particularly easy to spot, is the thing. I believe it is by one of these sort of... one of those things. So we've actually passed by it before. Most certainly. There it is. There we go. Okay. So, piece of the map part.
Kind of weird game.
It's so easy to sort of skip those, as you can see. So we've now got a much longer trek. Till the end of the episode, pretty much, because I'm sure we're probably running relatively over. So what we're going to do is we're going to quickly grab this, then fast travel back to Cindy. Or maybe we'll stay at a local haven. One of the two. Is there a local haven around there? Ah, there's got to be a haven around that area. So, we'll make a quick, so we find another Letty and Pepper, procurement point, and also a new parking spot, actually, the abandoned barn. It's important that whenever you discover new parking spots, it does allow you to fast travel there.
Ignis, how many royal arms are there?
As many as there have been kings, though not all would have survived to this day.
It's like a treasure.
So, we'll make our way, our slow and steady progress, all the way over. I have a feeling there definitely should be another haven along the way, so if not, we can fast travel back to Hammerhead and we'll stay there. We actually have a fair amount of experience to actually cash in, so maybe that would actually be not such a bad idea after all. So, let's just continue to make our way across. Let's check the map once more. So there's a treasure sort of at the tip of this area over here I don't think we've gotten before. Some more Letty and Potato. Whoops. Oh. Pick these up. Yeah, it's just sort of should be pretty much right around here. There we are. So we'll see what's in here, and then we're making.
Wear you out? Kinda. I feel groggy when I wake up in the morning.
You could try going to bed at a decent hour.
Yes, Mum. So anyway, That being that, I think now all we need to do is find this piece of the map, and then yeah, we'll be done pretty much. Traveling becomes much easier. I mean, once we unlock chocobos, obviously this sort of travel will become a hell of a lot sort of simpler. We won't need to be walking the entire way. We'll be able to take a nice, easy ride on our chocobo, and that will make things a lot quicker.
Real nice here.
Makes me want to take a nap.
So, here we go. This is the area we need to be searching for a little blue glint.
Wah!
So, I wonder where this could be. I think we can find it up here. There we go, lovely.
Surprise! Another map scrap!
Oh, the map is still incomplete.
So, we now have four pieces of the map, I believe. There are five in each area of the game. So there are five in Lead, five in Duskeye, five in Klain. I'm pretty sure that's how it works. So, given that I can't see actually any local havens, and I don't actually think there are any havens close by, disappointingly. So what that means we will do is we will most likely, therefore, fast travel back to the car. And then we'll talk to Cindy, obviously, to get our quest, to cash in our quest. And then we will stay at the caravan by Hammerhead, because... just because it makes sense to do so now. In doing so, we can... in doing so, we obviously get the multiplier across all of our previous... all of the other stuff.
My mother or something?
So,
the word.
There is Cindy.
You found it! Well, I'll be. And it's still in pretty good condition, too. Slap some of this wax on your car, and y'all be gliding down the road and saving gas, too.
Nice.
Don't go believing it out of hand, though. That's just what the rumors say, among a bunch of other things. Still, in every rumor there's a grain of truth. After all, when it comes to cars, Crown City folk know their business. It's a right shame they put up the wall 30 years ago. A lot of goods became the stuff of legend, including this wax.
That's too bad.
Pawpaw left the city and never looked back, so I've only ever come across what he had lying around the garage. But now that we got ourselves a can, why don't we crack her open and put those rumors to the test? Let me know if you want me to give you a hand with the waxing.
So, there we go. That is the quest there. We'll get some experience. We'll start the next quest in the next episode. I realize that we're probably very close.
The Crown City from the
neither have I, but she said it's the place where legends were made.
And goods produced in the Purlius have yet to match that caliber, even after 30 years.
Pretty impressive.
So, here we go. We're going to stay here. Stay for 30 gil.
Yeah.
Because we're staying here, it means that we won't actually be able to get food, I'm pretty sure, from Ignis. But that's no real trouble for us. We're just caring particularly about the... We just care about the experience for now, and we can certainly deal with everything else later. So, there we go. We get a nice chunk of experience. We're going to gain several levels. All the way up to level 18, we have a nice amount of AP. Gladiolus is now up to level 3, so he's going to start hoarding high potions for us. And now we can check out some of Prompto's photos as well. We see Monica.
Core.
We see Core. Well, that's a better photo of Core, actually.
Hey, this one's pretty good.
Resting a bit overexposed, but there we go. And that is going to be it for this episode. I hope you have enjoyed this episode of my walkthrough, I should say, of Final Fantasy XV. I hope you'll join me on the next.